The other aspect of dealing with your customers is don't let them go. These are not one-shot deals. You are building relationships. You want that executive to call you when he's going to put his mother's apartment on the market in Florida. She has to go to assisted living. Maybe you can make a referral fee, maybe not, but you can at least give them advice. You can do some research, see, you know, what the market's like there. You want to be the go-to person. And it can be some very rich person who's spend a lot of money with you, and then they say, my son's graduating from college, can you find him a studio rental? Mm-hmm. At least you can refer it to somebody competent. But you should never let go of that web of business that you're building, because these people will, for years and years and years, remember you as the as real estate, and they see your name. And you know, I don't believe in sending people nonstop emails or something like that. But if you send them a market update, it's nice, they call you, they're interested in what's going on in the market. I for the past 20 years have done the Christmas book scenario. Anybody who's sat near me in the office knows what this looks like. There's a pile about this high and about that wide of 800 books. And they get wrapped, they have a sticker in them, compliments of, there's a wonderful card that's a photograph of me and my team. They get wrapped, they get put in Corcoran bags, they get hand delivered to the buildings or sent by messenger or whatever to the offices. And the reply is unbelievable. It takes care of the first quarter of my year's business. But I'm sure you have many ideas that might be better. But the idea that somebody gets something for nothing after you've worked with them 8 or 10 years ago, it just gives them a wonderful feeling. They're remembered, they're thought of, there's this happy feeling that, and they call and they send notes, and then in the course of the conversation, it's, gee, you know, we were thinking of moving, but then we decided not to, or my daughter-in-law's, you know, I mean, you get into an engaging conversation that often results in some business. So even if it doesn't, you've made the contact and you've kept the contact. And then I used to send people cards their anniversary of when they sold there, which I still sometimes do. You know, this is the 5th anniversary of your purchase, and are you still happy there? Can I help you with anything? Sometimes I think, gee, it's been 5 years. Maybe I ought to move. You know, maybe we, you know, if you'd like to chat about the market, if you'd like, you know, these things generate interest, and if they're not interested, they throw it in the trash can. It's not like somebody every day sending you emails or, you know, being in your face too much or constantly trying to invite you to parties. Or, you know, people don't have time for that. They don't want to be bothered. But everybody likes to think they're still relevant in your life, especially if you don't necessarily have business with them then. They think, this is really nice. And I noticed that the National Association of Realtors has a statistic that says that 7 months after someone makes a purchase, 90% of them forget the name of the realtor. So if they forget your name, it's your fault. You know, you've got to find a way to bring them together and make them remember you in a very nice, courteous way.